wrestling in my doubts, in my failures you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence you won't let go, in the questions your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. My lighthouse, I will go to the promise, you will carry me safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore.
I won't fear what tomorrow brings, with each morning I'll rise and sing.
Good morning and welcome to Livestream Faith from All Saints Church, Woodlands and Highfields. It's lovely to have you here this morning from wherever you are. I can see there are people from Norfolk, people from Woodlands, people from Scawthorpe and Scoresby, Stoke-on-Trent, Shropshire and even Norway today. So welcome to you all. My name is Stephen Gardner. It's my privilege to be the vicar here at Woodlands and Highfields and also now the Oversight Minister for Carcroft, Skellow and Ostham. Thank you to everyone that came and supported me during my licensing on Tuesday. We're still going to be working out over the next few weeks and months what these roles feel like, how this works out. It's a new way of being a vicar for me, so please do bear with us as we work out how to help our partnership grow into the partnership we long it to be, and how we can learn from one another across our parishes and also serve one another as well. The second image on our notices is the word hope in 2021. Thanks, Dave. And that's what I have. I feel a huge sense of hope for what the future will hold. There's an awful lot of hard work between now and then, but we have hope. We are all saints. We are doors that have never been wider open. I don't remember the last time someone from Norway nipped into church on a Sunday morning, or for that matter, someone from Norfolk. Doors that have never been wider open, hearts that love, faith that shines. Our faith is shining brighter and brighter and brighter as this lockdown continues. It's hard. I know it's hard, but be blessed. Know that God is with you, and know that you are someone who is close to God's heart. That's why we're doing our series on the Beatitudes in these weeks. God is close to, we are close to God's heart. So we're reflecting on the Beatitudes because we want to be people whose hearts are like God's hearts, but also people who know that they are close to God's heart. It goes both ways. So that's why we're reflecting on this as we start this weird year. Last week, we decided that this was actually the 13th month of 2020. It's November 2020. And we'll celebrate New Year when we finally get there. We're live streaming every day. We're live streaming at 12 noon. Oscar and I are live streaming now every single day like we were during the first lockdown at midday. We're live streaming at 6 o'clock every day with Bible reading and some prayers. And then at 7 o'clock, we have our bedtime story. We're carrying on with that too. Ways of staying connected, ways of staying in touch, but ways that you can share as well. You can share some of those on your Facebook page. Maybe just share the bedtime story to start with, or share a particular 6 o'clock that you found particularly helpful or particularly moving, or that you think a friend might be blessed by. Use this Facebook streaming to connect with more people. Use it to bless people. Use it to reach out with the love of God, even in these weird times. Telephone church, our church for people that can't do the internet or don't do the internet. You can dial in and listen Saturday to Thursday at 6 p.m. each day. There's an interactive service at 11:30 on Sundays. If you know someone who's isolated at home, who might like to be a part of that, why not come with them? Say to them, look, I'll dial in with you. We'll speak to Stephen. We can have a practice, but then you can dial in. You can be a part of that and I'll come with you. I'll come to that service with you. But don't let people be on their own. If you think that they could benefit from being part of something different, something bigger, then invite them along. Share that. And if you want details of how to connect up to Telephone Church, just give me a buzz. After church this morning, we're going to have coffee together. That will be on Zoom. You'll need to message me or Liz Conway or on the church Facebook page for a link for that. We do, coffee's a big thing at All Saints. Tea and coffee after our services is a big thing. So we're carrying on that during lockdown. But also, we have this evening our Band of Brothers. It's our men's group. So tonight, 7:30 p.m., men, Zoom, message me for the link. Coffee. I said coffee was a big thing. Virtual coffee morning, Wednesdays at 10 a.m. on Telephone Church. You have to bring your own drinks and your own biscuits or your own cake, but come along. And we always say at the beginning, oh, there's not much to talk about, is there? And I always have to kick them off at 11 o'clock when I move on to Zoom for our Zoom virtual coffee morning. Come along, do come along, come and be a part of that. Come and connect together. In these times when we're separated, we can still be together. But before you come onto Zoom, make sure that you have made suitable preparations, especially if you have a ginger cat. Because some of you might not know that during my licensing on Tuesday, thank you. That was last Sunday. Thank you, Dave. What you won't know is that during my licensing on Tuesday, when Jackie was reading the gospel, the cat attempted to make an appearance from this side. And I was sat with my arm out like this on the edge of the screen, trying to stop the cat. And I could feel Jackie beginning to lose it as she was giggling away next to me. So the cat is not in the room today. Oscar's made sure of that. We can carry on without the need for the application of duct tape. The food bank. Thank you to our incredible food bank team. We are increasingly needed. We have more and more referrals every week. This week's quick shopping list is beans. Instant snacks, so mugshots, packet pasta, that sort of thing, or pot noodles or super noodles in the packets, those sort of instant snacks, but also ordinary pasta if you could. I'm so grateful to everyone that's donated. We have a fabulous stock of food that we're able to have in case there are shortages of anything. We are sorted, so thank you. But please, please, please keep donating. The more you donate, the more families we're able to help and support, and the more confidence we have in that. You will have seen last week, we said thank you to a guy called David Woodman, who is a musician, he's a professional musician, a friend of Dave Greenwood's. As part of supporting David, we were able to make use of him in recording some tracks for our worship. So last week in Who Can Sound the Depths of Sorrow, he played the slide guitar, as you can see in the bottom left-hand corner there. But also on another recording that we made, he played the hammer dulcimer. That's the image in the top left. If you're interested in checking out some new music, do go to Dave's website, davidwoodmanmusic.com. Have a look at some of the music that he's doing. He's got a Kickstarter out at present, trying to put a new album together. So do support him in that if you like his music. But then maybe share it with a friend if you think that that friend will like that music too. And I'll say a little bit more about the song that he helped us to record in just a few moments. Finally, today's beatitude is blessed are the meek. And I've been waiting to use this particular Reverend Fun cartoon. It's the image of a courtroom. And in the back of the courtroom, there are people. Is there a really angry orange guy in the back of that courtroom? Wasn't meant to be a political comment. And the lawyer is saying to some rather meek looking people, the earth is yours, but as expected, the non-meek are going to contest this ruling like crazy. I hadn't really taken on the political connotations of that. So moving swiftly onwards. So we're going to begin our service with our collect, the collect for Sunday, the 17th of January, the second Sunday of Epiphany. Eternal Lord, our beginning and our end, bring us with the whole creation to your glory, hidden through past ages, but made known in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now, at this point, we would normally say together the Diocesan Vision Prayer. But as those of you were able to make it for my licensing discovered, we were asked by the diocese if we could record the music for a new hymn that someone in the Diocese of Sheffield had written based on the Diocesan Vision Prayer. And the diocese asked us if we would be willing to record a version of that to share across the diocese. And so we do. So instead of saying our Diocesan Vision Prayer today, we're going to sing it. Renew your church with gifts of power.
With gifts of love, as those who bear your name. May we who know that we are loved tell others of the same. From lofty peak to water's edge, may your
So a slight change in our order of service. Before we have our next thing, we're going to stick in our photo challenge this week. Favourite food. I have to say, there's some of these that really I'm definitely going to try and some I might not. First up is Ken with his breaded chicken parmesan. There we are. It's fabulous, fabulous, fabulous recipe. So the recipes for all of these that have recipes will be up on the church's face, on the church's website this afternoon. I'll put a little recipes tab together, and all of these that have got recipes will have those up there. John Halford, his recipe for a hot curry is probably the same as Liz's. Liz's messaged me this morning and said, method one, ring the Agra. Two, enjoy having an Agra takeaway. So I think John's recipe is pretty much the same. Why try and make a curry when you've got a fabulous, fabulous Indian restaurant just down the road? Glynis, melting moments. Hands up all those who love their melting moments. And then Margaret, lentil soup. Now I have to say, this is possibly one that I wouldn't necessarily choose myself. But Margaret's lentil soup looks absolutely gorgeous. Next up, Jan. This is another one that's got a recipe like Margaret's creamy pork and apple casserole. Now, I have to say, this one really, 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 really made my mouth water. I can just imagine sitting down with the recipe for this and Glynis's melting moments as pudding. So, yeah, thank you for that. Another one that made my mouth water is Anita's homemade lasagna. Absolutely gorgeous picture there, Anita. It wasn't really a recipe, more just a sort of a, these are the things you'll need, and just sort of layer it together and cook it and it'll be fine. Fabulous, fabulous recipe. I'm reminded of the times when I say to Jack, I'm cooking something, which is rare because Jackie's much better at it than I am. And I say, how much of such and such? And Jackie says, some. I try and get my own back when she's asking something about the computer. You know, how far should I scroll down? Some. So homemade lasagna. I'll try and find a nice recipe for that for those that haven't got the details of that. But that's a gorgeous picture, Anita. Thank you. Next up is Lisa with bacon and chorizo linguine. Now, this does actually look quite nice. The only problem I have is I'm not a fan of chorizo, so I might just need to put some extra bacon in. But the image of that is absolutely gorgeous. Thank you, Lisa, for that one. Next up is Sal with her chili non carne, because Sal's a vegetarian. So Sal eats vegetarian food. The original title for this on the recipe that Sal posted was chili sin carne, because in the right recipe that's con, sin is without. But I really didn't feel that I could call a recipe on church on a Sunday morning chili sin carne. So it's chili non carne, and that's what it'll be on the website. Thank you, Sal. A little foreign contribution, Christopher Briggs, who now lives in Norway. Some of you will remember Christopher. He was an organist. He played the organ at All Saints Church for several years. And he is with us this morning. He's on the live stream. So good morning and welcome to you, Christopher. But Arctic char, I've never had Arctic char, pan-seared. Chris linked a YouTube video of how to prepare that. So I'll link that on the recipe page on the church website. But that looks, I'm not a fan of seafood, but that is making my mouth water as I'm sat here. So thank you very much for that. Next up is Joan Jones deep filled pizza. And there's a gorgeous recipe for this. The only thing you have to avoid is breaking your oven when you're making it, because that's what Joan managed to do this week. So Joan, I hope your new oven has arrived and that the recipe doesn't require you to sacrifice an oven as part of the preparation for it. The next one is not Bob's necessarily his favourite food, but it's his favourite recipe for impossible pie. And I'll copy the original directly onto the recipe page, because this came from an old newsletter that went out around Highfields. And apparently what you do is just mix all the ingredients together and it separates itself out into the crust and the custard and then coconut flakes on top. Well, I'm trying something other than coconut because I'm not really a fan. But I shall enjoy looking forward to attempting impossible pie. Our next favourite food is Matty. Sausage, beans and mash. And here is Matty eating it. But Matty included a method for its preparation, which is... Oh, sorry. I can't read that on my screen, so I'm just going to have to make that bigger on here. Send Daddy to the kitchen. One, help peel one of the potatoes. Three, run around the kitchen for 20 minutes. Four, demand tomato sauce regardless of the meal being served. And why not? So thank you for your... Oh, sausage, beans and mash. That really is making my mouth water at this point. Next up is mine, which is lovingly known as pork thing. It's a sticky barbecue pork recipe that dates from the first microwave that our family ever had. My mum got a microwave and had this beautiful microwave cookbook. And we were looking through and we found barbecued spare ribs. And we said, oh, can we do that? And my mum said, I'm not spending money buying bones that we don't eat. So she brought pork. And over the course of a few years, that recipe transmogrified into what's lovingly now known as pork thing. And it is my favourite recipe. I shall make sure the recipe for Gardner Family pork thing is on the website as well. As I will for the recipe for Vicky's big soup. Now, I have to say that looks more like a stew than soup to me. But apparently all you do is you get a pot and you just keep throwing vegetables at it. From the days when Vicky was farming, and they didn't have time during lambing season to make food, they would just keep this pot bubbling away to itself on a daily basis and just kept adding vegetables in at random. I quite like that idea. That rather feels like a lockdown sort of food. You just have something bubbling on the stove and throw food at it and eat whatever comes out. But our final favourite food today is Dave with his chocolate orange. And here is a picture of Dave's chocolate orange, complete with a rather late Christmas tree. But more importantly, here is the method for Dave's chocolate orange. One, realise nobody brought you your favourite at Christmas. Two, add that fact to Facebook for equal parts sympathy and hope. Three, wait 2 days. Four, celebrate a good friend arriving at the doorstep with a surprise. Five, serves two. Because this really was Dave's chocolate orange. So all I can say is if you spot one out there in the wild, my dear live stream friends, could you procure one on my behalf for Dave?
Yes.
And
if you can procure
a second one for Sal, then and probably a third one for Wendy, and a fourth one to share between Matty and George.
No, they're all Dave's.
I will remunerate. I have a message in my ear saying that they're all Dave's. I will remunerate you suitably. So if you do see a chocolate orange in the wild, please could you grab some for me? And we'll make sure they go to our wonderful, fabulous super producer, Dave. So we carry on with our worship and we sing the hymn, And Can It Be?
Die for me, He left his Father's throne above, so free, so infinite his grace, emptied himself of all but love, and bled for Adam's helpless race. 'Tis mercy all immense and free, for oh my God, it found out me. 'Tis mercy
reading is from Isaiah 53, verses 1 to 7. Who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain, like one from whom people hide their faces. He was despised, and we held him in low esteem. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that was brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
So this week from the Beatitudes, blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. What does meek mean? Well, meek is a very strange word. Meek in the dictionary is quiet, gentle, and submissive. But it's also often used in a negative way. He was a very meek little person, someone who's easily imposed upon, someone who's, oh, no, if it's all right, if it's perfectly all right with you, that would be lovely. Thank you. Just don't want to be any trouble. That's the image we have of someone who is meek. And that doesn't sit well with me. Jesus is often described as meek. And yet, this Jesus is someone who made a whip of cords and drove money changers out of the temple. This Jesus is the one who called the religious leaders of his day hypocrites. That doesn't feel like the definition of meek. So what do we mean? What does being meek mean for you and I? What does it mean for those who are meek to be close to God's heart? Well, I think the bit of the definition that helps me to start is that word submissive. Are we willing to submit to God? Or do we want God to be like an equal partner? You know, do we want God to, you know, do we have God along because, you know, he's a good bloke to have, you know, nice person to have on the journey, but, you know, I get to make my own decisions just as much as he does. No. Come across a lot of people who seem to think like that, for whom God is their co-pilot. There's a memes on the internet, you know, God, Jesus is my co-pilot. And the response to that, well, if Jesus is your co-pilot, I think you're sitting in the wrong seat. We need to be people who are willing to submit. There's those wonderful verses in Ephesians, which are often misused, where Paul says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave up his life for her. He's saying the same thing to both husbands and wives, to each of us. Submit to one another. To be meek, to be biblically meek, is to be willing to submit to someone else whom God has called, to say, you first. I'm going to lift you up. I'm going to put you forward. I'm going to encourage you. And I'm not going to insist on standing in the limelight. But it also does mean to be gentle. I don't know about you, but every so often I come across someone who's a friend and follower of Jesus who feels like they've left their headlights on full beam. Do you know what I mean? They're the sort of people who are just like, whoa, praise God, isn't God good? Have you done it right? Are you with God? Are you sorted with God? And you think, whoa, mate, just give me a moment here. One, yes, I'm okay with God, thank you very much. Two, you don't need to shout. And three, you're not going to persuade anyone to become a friend of Jesus by behaving like that. Why will the meek inherit the earth? Because they're the people who gently and quietly, in conversation and relationship and friendship, will earn the opportunity to be able to speak of the love of Jesus. The meek will inherit the earth because they are the people who are attractive. They are the people whom people will follow. Now, I'm not saying you can't be bouncy. I'm not saying you can't be the sort of the Tigger-like outward going personality. But we can't overwhelm people. We can't force our views onto other people. Jesus didn't. God doesn't. The Holy Spirit doesn't. The Father doesn't. So we shouldn't. It's one other thing about meek that comes from our reading from Isaiah. Jesus, at his crucifixion, was entirely submissive. He didn't say more than a couple of words. This wonderful passage, as a sheep before her shearers is silent. Jesus' submission in that circumstance was about realizing that God was with him, that God would sort that situation out. Many years ago, Jackie and I were at a conference where there was a guy called John Bevere talking about being under authority. And he suggested that there are moments when, even when there are people in authority over us or people at the same level as us who behave badly, we are not always called to speak against that publicly. We're not always called to denounce what we see as bad behavior. Someone will be, the right person in the right way at the right time. But we need to be careful we don't make the assumption it's always us that should do that. And in these days, when we look around at those who maybe aren't sticking to the restrictions the way that we think they ought to, who aren't staying at home when we think they ought to, who aren't behaving in the supermarkets the way we want them to, there is a time to say, excuse me, could you just step back a bit, please? There is a time to say to perhaps to a manager of a shop, this is really unsafe, please, could you do something about it? But not to start screaming and shouting and yelling and raging at people. That's what it means to be meek. To be gentle in the way we deal with those who don't live up to the standards that we have. And then to be gentle with ourselves when we don't live up to those standards either. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. We don't have to work. You don't work for an inheritance. An inheritance is coming to you regardless. So I just want to encourage you this week to submit to God again, to say yes to him again, and to say, God, what do you want me to do? Before you do it. And at this point, the traditional preacher, where the preacher has one finger pointing forwards and three fingers pointing backwards, is definitely in play here. Before you act this week, God, what do you want me to do? Submit yourselves to God, therefore, as dearly loved children. Let's be gentle with those around us. Let's be gentle, especially with our families and our friends who are feeling the burn. Let's be gentle with the people who aren't doing what we think they ought to be doing. Let's speak up when we see injustice. Let's speak against injustice. Yes, let's not let meekness be the only thing that we do. Like Jesus, we have times when we need to be angry. We have times when we need to be apt. But I think, certainly for me, and maybe for some of you, there are times I need to practice meekness as well. And so as we allow ourselves to submit to God, as we allow God's Spirit to teach us meekness, we become a people who are close to God's heart. And as we demonstrate that ourselves in our lives and in our relationships, we show ourselves to be people whose hearts are close to God's heart. So if you're naturally a more forthright sort of person, don't know what you mean, then pray that God would help you to be meek this week. Not a doormat. Jesus was never a doormat. But submit yourself to God and see what he can do when you are gentle and kind and quiet when he calls you to be. Let's pray. Jesus, would you fill our hearts with your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel, of knowledge, the Spirit of the fear of the Lord, but also the Spirit of gentleness and calm, the Spirit of meekness. Lord, would you teach us what it means to be blessed as the meek? And would you remind us that we too will inherit the earth? Amen. And so we're going to remind ourselves that Jesus himself became a tiny baby. We continue to think about the incredible message of Christmas. We continue to celebrate that Jesus was willing to give up all of the status of heaven in order to show us what it means to truly love. The one who flung his hands flung stars into space, surrendered them to nails. The one who was the Lord and King and God knelt and washed his disciples' feet. As we sing this song, let's let God's Spirit teach us what it means to be truly meek and be blessed. From heaven you came, helpless babe.
To bring our lives as a daily offer. Mary leading our prayers this morning. Loving Father, we come this morning knowing you are more willing to listen than we are to pray. Usually our prayers are more of a desperate last resort than our first thought. So forgive us, Lord, and hear our prayers. We pray for your world, a world with many conflicts and wars. We pray particularly for your people, many who are being killed, tortured, and imprisoned because they would not recant their faith in you. We thank you that you strengthen them to enable them to make right choices despite the hardships and pain they suffered, just as you did in your time on earth. We thank you for their courage and deep faith to stand firm in the face of many dangers. Lord, we ask that you bless them, strengthen them, and safeguard them from their enemies. Lord, in your mercy. Father, we pray for your church, where much of the time we are lukewarm about our faith. We deny you many times so that we can lead quiet, peaceful lives. Lord, give us a willingness to speak out for you in our communities. Focus our minds and hearts on the task of extending your kingdom. Guard our hearts and minds and wills and those of our children to the many temptations in the world, drugs, wrong relationship, anything that would mar our relationship with you. Help all of us to stand firm on that narrow road and embrace the discipleship and lifestyle that you show to us, so that we may be effective witnesses in this place. Bless Stephen in this new phase of his ministry as priest in charge of Adwy Osun as fellow and those who will be helping him in this mission. Lord, in your mercy. Finally, Father, we pray for anyone who may be sick in body, mind or spirit. And I ask you now to speak out their names aloud or silently in your hearts. I pray for Dot, my neighbour, Pat, my sister-in-law, the Conway family as they mourn the death of Kevin's aunt, and Maggie, who is coping with the death of Bill. Loving God, show yourself to those who are vulnerable and make your home with the poor and weak. We ask that you protect the healthy, calm the frightened, give courage to those in pain, comfort the dying and console the bereaved, and those who watch and wait, and strengthen all those who have a caring role in whatever capacity, including NHS staff. And in your mercy, heal all those who cry out to you this day. We ask all these things in the name of our Saviour, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we gather all our prayers together as we pray in word and sign the prayer that Jesus taught us, and we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So, next week's challenge. I don't know if it might be a bit early for this, but I'm going to suggest we have signs of spring. Glynis suggested it a couple of weeks ago. Signs of spring. Get out there on your exercise walks. Get out there into your gardens and find some evidence that spring is on its way. And let's encourage one another as the days get lighter. The snow has finally melted from the vicarage gardens. Let's celebrate that life is returning to the earth. And we celebrate that life will return to normal soon. We've got some dark days ahead of us still. Just like the misery of the end of winter and the beginning of spring. But Let's look for signs of hope around us. Yeah, let's make it that. Signs of hope, rather than signs of spring, signs of hope. That might just be something a little bit bigger to get your teeth into. Don't forget, Band of Brothers tonight, 7:30. Message Kev for the link for that. Don't forget to join us for coffee after the service today. Don't forget that you are not on your own. Jesus is with you. The Holy Spirit is with you. The Father is with you. And we're here. If you're struggling this week, if you're feeling the burn this week, ring someone. Ring me, ring someone else in the church family. Message someone that you've spotted on the messenger group or on the Facebook comments and just say, can you pray for me? Can I chat? Let's stay even more connected together as we work out how we navigate through these strange and difficult days. So we're going to sing our final song before the blessing. It's a song that speaks of our trust in God. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Let's worship. Let's commit ourselves again to God as we sing these words.
Bless the
So this is our latest recruit for guide dogs. Many of you will know we puppy walk for the Guide Dog Association. This is our latest pup. He's just 8 weeks old. We're not allowed to share his name online because he's a sponsored pup. So you have to be careful for his sponsors. But he's known online as Guide Dog Puppy K, the letter K. This is our latest recruit who's been reducing the amount of sleep we've had in the Gardner household this week, but not by much. So you'll see a bit more of him as the weeks go by. And maybe, we hope, soon you'll be able to say hello to him in person. So prayer of blessing. May the God of all comfort give you comfort. May the God of all grace give you grace. May the God of peace grant you his peace. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. So, saints of God, stay at home in peace. Be meek. Practice being meek to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Good news to all and hope.